In this video, I'm going to show you the signature rules tester, which allows you to see what signature would apply if you were to send an email with that sender, that recipient, and that message content. So in here, I have a few different signatures. Some are for external emails. Some will only be applied during a limited time. Some will only be applied on emails to colleagues. So let's click Signature Rules Tester, and let's say, hypothetically, I'm sending an email not to a colleague, but to someone outside my organization. And I could put whatever I want in the message body. If you wanted to test the reply signature feature, you could put in the text that we're looking out for to know when we should add a reply signature. But in my case, this is very simple. I just want to see what signature goes on emails to customers. So I'll click test. Perfect. It's shown me a little preview of this signature with my details filled in with all the signature layout. This is how the email would look with my signature added. But if I go over into details, we can also see why that signature was added. So if I click over here, it's got the names of various signatures. We've got product team banner. And as you can see, this is the one that includes a banner. Yes, we got a little check mark, a little tick. It's saying this one was applied because the sender is bradshepherd@greenorg.net. That's right. And server-side signatures is switched on. And the recipient is external. It's karen@affinitry.com. I don't have any other settings that would affect it. And so indeed, the signature is applied. Now, I've set this to process the next signature, so it's going to go through any other signatures. You can also set it so it just adds the first one that matches and ignores any after it. Now, if we go to the next signature, because it's also processed that one, in here, it's saying that, yeah, the sender's Brad Shepherd, yeah, the recipient's external, but this date range doesn't apply. It isn't between the 8th of August and the 9th of September. I'm recording this towards the end of July. So these dates, this date range, don't apply. So signature not applied. Then this one, this last one named internal, as you can guess, yes, I am the sender and it's set to apply to me and that's great, but the recipient needs to be internal for this one to apply. And remember, Karen there is external to my company. All right, then let's change this around. Let's say that it's gonna go to my colleagues in support. All right, let's see what signature would apply. We'll run test. And you can see it's the simpler cut down internal signature. And again, I don't wanna take up your whole day looking at various rules applied or not applied, but you can see, well, the recipient's not external. So if we go to this bottom one, the recipient is internal there within the Green Org company. So great, we're gonna apply that signature. Sender is Brad Shepherd too. So in here, these various settings under select users, signature rules, the date range, we're gonna look at all of those to determine what signature would be added, and we'll show you a preview and then explain why that one was added. Thanks for watching.